gentlemen, boys and girls, get ready. This is the second to last part of Metal Arms and Glitch of the System. That's right. Next part, we go fight the boss. But for now, we have some needless padding that we've got to get through. Ah, God. Agent Shush will explain more once we get into the level. But this is Bringing It Down. Inside the Mill Space Station. And here's Agent Shush to explain more. Agent Shush, if you would.
Mitch, where the hell are you, Clankfoot? Do you read me, soldier? I have vital information. We found a way to shut down the mills. We studied that mill operating system chip and discovered the mill shutdown code. But it can only be done from the Master Mill Control Center. The space station schematics reveal that it is located near your current location. You can shut them down forever!
Wait, so I gotta fight through an army of cutthroat robots in order to be able to shut down the vast army that's enslaving my planet and possibly take down the big boss monster himself just by walking down a few corridors. Sounds like a good plan to me. Let's get to this. All right! Since you are a robot, there's no need to breathe, so anybody thinking, why the heck can you move around outside in space without a suit is retarded right about now. Okay. In this level, you will fight pretty much one of every robot with the exception of the elites. The elites are nowhere to be found in this level, and with good reason. There's no reason for them to be here since we have Titan. But we do actually have to come down this way. If I remember correctly, that's because there's a chip or something that we need to open that door. This egret's getting on my freaking nerves. And of course, there's one lone mill grunt who hasn't gotten the clue to kick the bucket yet. So, since he's so resilient, yeah, your body's mine, bitch. Trooper, report. Must be your first assignment. Blah, blah, blah. Intruder. Yeah. Who's gonna believe you? You just didn't hear the screaming, did you? God, I love mill grunts. They're so retarded. But yes. That was probably one of the best performances you can give as a mill grunt, and one of the most satisfying, especially if you're on the other side of this pillar right here, and you can just blow the crap out of pretty much anybody with a rocket launcher that you can find. Okay, so... Oh, wow, okay, I didn't see you. Ah, you have a shield. Bastard! And I just need two shots. There we go. Good as new. Alright. We do need a chip to get through this door, if I remember correctly. Wow, some Ripper ammo? Really? And the chip should be somewhere. Where's my chip? I would like my frickin' computer chip to get in the frickin' door. Computer chip. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Guess I couldn't pick you up when I destroyed that mill as a mill. Alright. So, when you open up this door, you will go down a hallway. You'll go down about three of these, and there'll pretty much always be some ammunition and a full life upgrade. Now, what could be harder than a couple of egrets? Well, two grunts with shields for one. I hate shielded enemies in this game. Absolutely hate shielded enemies. But oh no, they're not the worst part about this. The mills by now, with that little, with the last level, have pretty much figured out that you're on the ship and you're trying to track them down and murder all of them. Which, difficult. I love the spew gun. I really do. It's just one of the... Once it gets fully upgraded, it's just awesome. But... Yeah, there are... other things that pop up in this particular hallway that just annoy the crap out of me. And those being... Yep! You see right, folks, we've got to deal with a big bad night. And we don't want to use our recruiter grenades or our EMP grenades just yet. We want to save those. Ah! Damn it! These rooms also act as checkpoints, so you don't have to really worry about dying in this particular level. And if you can draw the grunts off of the platform that they're on, or catch the missile in the door, glitch it like that, which, by the way, I've tried to duplicate this process. It is hard as hell to catch a missile in the door. But yeah, apparently those giant saucers in the middle of the floor are elevators. Who would have guessed that? Apparently, I don't need ammunition for my spew gun. Probably should have, reloaded it beforehand, but whatever. I know there's a Titan coming up, so I might as well inflict a little bit of damage while, utilizing a hasty retreat. If there weren't two frickin', okay. With that flame grenade, that Titan should go down. Now we just have to wait for the fires to go out, and... Yep. Oh, God! Not out! They were not out! Not good. But I did get those two grunts on the first pass, so... Yeah, looks like there's an egret right there that I can hack into. Awesome! Makes this next part extremely easy. Especially since these egrets stay dormant until they sense an enemy presence nearby, and usually that sense is either triggered by a droid processing chip, or... Oh, okay. Mills, lots of mills, or being shot at, that's what I was thinking about. Now you may be wondering, isn't all this jumping around a little unnecessary? Not really. I find that it's a lot harder to shoot a target that's up in the air, that's just kind of passively going from side to side with the enemies. Of course, I'm only playing on normal. I'd be crazy to go for nuts of steel. And that's how you get the drop on those particular enemies. And crap, I lost the signal, which means that that thing is going to be ready and waiting to kill me. Along with apparently a lot of other stuff that's ready, willing, and able to kill me. Wow, I got one, and... Wow! That was retarded. Ah, crap, I just used my last flame grenade. I'm gonna need that later. Oh well. It's just- Ow! Ow! Fire! Fire! Why does it hurt so much when I'm made of metal? Yes, but if you don't have an egret, you do have a little pin bot there. That will shoot for you whenever you run into stuff. Well, whenever you shoot. Oh, right. The these sentries are what's keeping the laser gate down, if I remember correctly. All you've got to do is take care of them, and the gate should... Well, that's retarded. Okay, so... Yeah, I don't know what to do. I think I'm gonna put this egret... Okay. There we go. There's a button up here on this ledge, which is why there are two vents down there. Okay. So, I'll just hop out of this. With the door closed. And then we can move on. Huh. Tight level. But, if I remember correctly, we're actually almost done. Wow, my memory sucks, apparently. We're only halfway done with the frickin' video. Okay. This is actually pretty much where the rest of the level is gonna take place. You pretty much go around in a circle right here. And, that Titan is more than happy to show you what eternity looks like. And actually, if you can, you might want to try and hack into these egrets that are over here before that Titan sees you. There we go. Okay, now I got a full health, mother. Screwed. Alright. So, after two attempts, the Titan will figure out who you are and that you're hacking into the egrets, and it will just continue to attack any egret that it views as hostile, because all egrets, as I said, are supposed to be stationary until a time deemed when an enemy is nearby. So, did I take out the Titan? I don't think I took it out. Did it fall in the... No, it didn't fall in the... Where'd it go? Okay. Weird. But whatever. This would be where the rest of the level is, so I'm just going to drop off. Well, okay. I guess I can take it. Whoa! There you went! Okay. And bada bing. You're gone. You're gone. Wow, I'm just ripping shit up with this guy. Oh, and I lost the signal, damn it. Oh well, I can hack into him in a second. As you saw, there was a recruiter grenade down there, very useful. Another EMP grenade, you'll need that for later. And as long as that egret doesn't turn around, I should be able to hack into him from here, and voila! Oh, hey, a flame grenade, awesome. This is the next area. Whoa! I hate that these guys keep popping up around. And I apparently hit a checkpoint by accident, which means that I will pretty much be... Damn it! The level... Okay, that's interesting. The level hadn't loaded yet. Oh, crap. That's right. I didn't take care of all of them, did I? No, they jumped over the wall. That's how I didn't take care of them. that is a bad idea. Where is my... Well, not that. Okay, spew gun it is. Rat-a-tat-tat, dance for me, mother. Ow, ow, ow! Stand still, you... There we go. Huh. Okay, what's down here? Nothing! Awesome. Scatter blaster, more spew ammunition, rocket launcher, always favored. If you haven't picked up, there's ammunition and stuff in all of these little crates that are out here, so if you are running low on pretty much anything, just blow the crap out of a couple of those and you should be good. And more? Just make a break for the frickin' door. Damn it, I thought I could sneak up on him. Scatter blaster. Scatter blaster. Don't think that one actually made contact. And wait, how did you get over here? Whatever, just die. Thank you. The worst part is if I die, I've got to do all this over again. But, to be fair, I've got a lot of health. I thought that I was honestly going to do a lot worse in this level. Like, a lot worse. And, no, you had already previously taken damage due to the egret disguise that I was wearing earlier. More spew gun ammo! Woo! Alright, this is the level that everybody knows about. There is a, turret. There's a cannon that you can hack into, that you can see moving back and forth kind of in the background. I honestly have no clue how to get to that. I have never used it. I mostly just do this. I know for a fact that there is a cannon somewhere around here, but I just prefer to go hand to hand. Well, not hand-to-hand per se, but you know what I mean. Now, if you're feeling really ballsy, there's a Titan down there, and you can take him and everybody else and their mother on right off the bat. Okay, come on, you egret. I know you can get up here and Hey! I'm sorry, your head's missing now. Oh, you bastard. Yeah, the legs sometimes tend to push you off, and why do you keep dancing around me? There we go. Good as dead. Okay, Titan. Got it! And this is another way you can be really ballsy. Instead of taking on the Titan, wait until he's facing the opposite direction, hack into him, and then use him to kill all of his friends! Ah, good times. Good times. And on again. Yes! Now all I gotta do is take care of these egrets before they manage to beat the living snot out of me with those plasma guns. I think it's plasma. I can't think of any way it would be a green laser. Green lasers just don't seem that plausible to me. Crap! Spew gun, let's get motoring. One down. There's a grenadier around here somewhere. Three! Awesome! Alright. And as soon as we head through the door, that will be the end of the level. Alright, guys. I am ShadeGrey. And this is me signing off. Next time, we go fight Corrosive himself. Later, and I hope you have a spectacular evening.